research organization is now looking forward to a manned mission in space, Gaganyaan. Let's quickly cut across and listen in to Dr. K Sivan, Chairman,
Indian exactly Space happened? Research so Organization. What could you note, what could you make out in the last few moments of landing?
See, this power descent from 30 kilometers to up to soft landing contains four different phases. That is the rough braking phase, second one is a coasting phase, third one is fine braking phase, and fourth one is terminal phase. If you are seeing this, what really happened in this mission, the first three phases were executed nicely, and in the last portion was not executed the right way. Okay. And so that in that phase only we lost a link with the lander. And that's what we are telling, that it is we could not establish the communication subsequently.
Right.
This one.
So now what next? Because the orbiter is still there. How do you look at this entire mission? With the orbiter working in good parameters, in good health.
So before that, I want to just tell that during the morning that session that our Honorable Prime Minister also was present in that when we were executing that task. And at the end that he gave a speech that actually our Honorable Prime Minister is that a source of inspiration and support for all of us. And his speech really gave us that the motivation for all of us. In this speech, one special word, at least that phrase I can say, that I noted from the Honorable Prime Minister's speech, that is what he said was, science should not be looked for the result, science should be for the experiment. And the experiment will lead to result. That is the type of statement he made.
It was very motivating for the team working on Isro mission.
It's really motivating. That particular the words were really motivating, and extremely that people are happy, that got motivated after his speech. And if you are seeing that Chandrayaan-2 mission, it had two objectives. One was science, another one was a technology demonstration. The science part mostly put as a part of orbiter, and technology demonstration is mainly for a landing and rover. This is a part. Now, if you are saying that the scientific part, the what really happened in that orbiter, I would say some few payloads, they are very special payloads. The one is that is we have, that is a dual band SAR, that is with both L band and S band.
Right.
All the moon orbiter till now flown have only single band, that is S band, is including Chandrayaan-1. And in this mission only we introduced that L band SAR also. What is the speciality of this particular the L band, that SAR is, it can penetrate to the subsurface up to 10 meters. And it will be finding the polar region, that is water and ice. That is a speciality of that one.
So Chandrayaan-2 had 500 meter resolution. So you are giving us 50 times more resolutions in this.
Resolution. Another one is that our the resolution, that high resolution camera what we have.
Yes.
That also, that is a 0.32 meter the resolution we have. The camera, and yet another one is that the imaging IR spectrometer.
Mm-hmm.
That is all along that the people are using this only that the 3 micron wavelength.
Okay.
Whereas we have in this mission that the 5 micron wavelength system. So all these things give a special attention to this particular orbiter. And it is this the payload, whatever we have put in the orbiter, is going to create a lot of data, and that is going to give the new science.
Mm-hmm.
So that way, I would say that orbiter is really functioning very well, and the science part is whatever required is already we met.
Okay, the science mission is complete, but the technology demonstrator, which you took up as a challenge, that still remains to be analyzed.
Yes, that is that regarding that technology demonstration part, that is the landing and a rover. Here also, that is, we could go up to 2 kilometers from 30 kilometers. Only that final phase, only that we could not demonstrate properly by the time that we lost the communication. Mm-hmm. So that way, that also, I would say that it is as 90-95% of the technology demonstration already we have done. So in total, the Chandrayaan-2 mission, it is very close to 100% success,
okay.
I would say.
Okay. So now, the data, what the orbiter will give, how is the world going to look at this data? Because a lot of scientists are interested in this orbiter data, right?
Yes, that is the number one. This is our orbiter is going around the moon in the polar orbit. And using this dual band SR, the SR data, and we can do a lot of research using the near the polar region. So that way, it is the first time such data is available to scientists globally.
Okay.
And also, there is that imaging, the infrastructure, the IR spectrometer data also is available for the global scientists.
Okay.
And the high-resolution imaging, using the high-resolution camera, that is going to be available also for the world community.
You said it will be 7 years, the orbiter lifetime will be 7 years. So will you have different timeline for achieving different experiments, targets for different experiments in the 7 years?
Now this, our designated the lifetime was only 1 year.
Yeah.
But because we have the extra fuel right now is available in the orbiter, that at present that orbiter life is estimated as 7.5 years. And the science, whatever we are going to do, it is not only 1 year, it is going to be for 7.5 years.
Okay.
What the speciality of the 7.5 years for this science is, what I talked to us about that high resolution, the camera imaging, that is that the swath is small. So because of the long duration, that we will be able to completely cover the entire globe of the moon.
Okay, so the fact that it was very challenging mission, the technology demonstrator, the lander, you had given the time for Vikram 14 days, rover will have 14 days, which is equal to one lunar day as such. So is there something, you know, during this period, that 14 days time, you still can look for some more information as to what went wrong?
Yes, definitely. That is right now the communication is lost, but we will be trying to communicate, trying to establish a link.
Okay.
That effort will be going on. Maybe next 14 days we will try.
Okay.
And if at all we are succeeding, that we will be able to operate that payloads.
Mm-hmm.
And the required data will get it.
Okay. So the orbiter will also be searching. Is that what you are saying?
That also we will do parallelly, this one.
This mission, will that delay other projects in line, because you have another ambitious project, Gaganyaan, and there are more projects on the anvil. So how do you look at this entire thing?
No, this the project is not all going to affect any of our ongoing activities. And immediately we are going to have that the CARTO3's mission that is going to be there at the end of October. Then subsequently, within a week time also, we will be having that RISAT-2BR-1 mission. Then we have that our the flagship program, that is the Gaganyaan project. It is that we are working very seriously to get the first unmanned flight by end of 2020. And like that, we have many, many other projects. Our hands are full, and we are very extremely busy with those activities. Whatever happened today is not going to affect any of the ongoing activities.
So it is work as usual for the scientists in ISRO. And sir, also the fact that yesterday the children, the students who were watching this entire mission, they saw this and they knew very well what were the scientific challenges before you. They refused to accept this as a failure. So many people say that, you know, this entire project was taken to very closer to the common man. So people know what went wrong. So there was enough information available about this project. So children refused to accept this as a failure. Well, how do you look at this?
That is the characteristic of the children. There's a curiosity also they can understand much better than anybody else because their mind is very, very clear. And what their observation is fully right. And the mission, whatever we talked, it is not a failure. We are not having any setback. Yes, we have a small percentage of information we lost, that's all. Otherwise, that they are right. And also that is by keeping the children that it is having more and more inspiration for all of us. Because they are showing, we are shown to them what they are supposed to do in future. So that way they learned, I'm sure that they would have learned a lot of things from yesterday's visit, and they will induced to do the scientific research by this process.
And the Prime Minister's word of encouragement and motivation to the entire team. So how's the mood in the team who were working on this Chandrayaan 2?
Now, Prime Minister is always the great the source of strength and inspiration for all of us. And his words were really was encouraging. And when people are slightly down with that untoward incident towards the end of the landing phase, but his words really put us back in the track. And now we are enthusiastically working on the mission. Also now we have many more missions on the hand. Also that we have that even that orbiter mission. Mm-hmm. That is we need to do a lot of analysis. So this all those things that it gave there, the speech gave the real motivation for us to continue.
So the mission continues?
Yes.
Okay. That is the ISRO chairman K Sivan smiling today because he knows that there is still a lot to do on this Chandrayaan 2 because the orbiter is in place and there is a lot of data that is expected which will help the world community in analyzing this data. And also the set designs of this mission will be analyzed with the data collected by the...
A quick break coming up next. National Security Advisor Ajit Doval.